Yo, what is going on, guys? Welcome back. Yesterday during the stream, quite a few people asked me, what is my deck setup for women's war games? Well, we're going to go over that in today's video. Now, I did make a strategy guide back in season 10. If you want to check that out, the link will be in the description. It's going to be very similar to this. There's going to be, I guess, one key difference, and that is the sandbag cards that are being used in this season. Last season, WrestleMania 39 was the lowest tier. You could use either WrestleMania 39 or Myth, which had stats around 35 or 40, somewhere around that. Your support cards were anywhere from 10 to 15 times those stats. So your support cards were about 400, 500, 600 total stats. This season, at least so far, being that it's the very beginning of the season, it is not like that at all. The stats of the lowest tier, WrestleMania 40, is going to be around 700, 800, 900. Your stats are only going to be in the thousands, possibly in the high thousands. And so only about two times. So I do want to say this before we start. Obviously, this hasn't been tested yet, but so many people asked me about my deck yesterday that I wanted to get this out, show you the reason behind me doing this, and kind of share, I guess, the what I'm thinking and some alternate methods, because not everybody's going to have this exact deck setup. But I did do a little research and kind of give you some alternate setup types for pretty much anybody that is playing this game right now, even if you're just starting now. All right, so first thing you need to do is go to your support cards. Don't put in your superstars yet. Just go to your support cards, and you're gonna pick a two-stat manager that is kind of your best two-stat manager. Like I said, there's going to be a bunch of alternate options, and we have, what, 6 two-stat managers in the game right now. And it's going to be any combination of those two stats. And so once you've seen what two-stat managers you have, you're going to pick your action supports that balance, or they're the alternate stats of your two-stat manager. So for me, Ted DiBiase, power, charisma, which means I'm going to want an action support of toughness and speed. If you have, say, a Paul Heyman that is power toughness, you're going to want pump it up, which is speed charisma. And so just depending on whatever manager you have, you're going to pick action supports that have the opposite of those stats. Another possibility is going to be second wind, just depending on how good your second wind are, or if you need a second wind. So now that we have the action supports and the managers set up, we're going to pick our superstars. And this setup is certainly going to be not just throwing in random WrestleMania 40s. No, these are specifically chosen based on my manager. And what we're going to do is that we're going to pick superstars whose activation is going to be the opposite of our manager. And so since our manager, when the match starts, is going to boost up our power and charisma, we're going to pick all superstars that have power and charisma as the worst stats on the card. And for us, there are only two superstars in this particular case. It's going to be Roxanne Perez, and it's going to be Io Sky. And so the idea is that when all of these superstars, or when the match starts, the power and charisma, which is my two worst stats, is going to get boosted by my manager card. And that way, my toughness and speed, they are already boosted and they are already high. It's going to give me the best shot and the best stats in each of the rounds. And now, since my power charisma is boosted, my action supports, since I can only cover two of the three rounds, my action supports are going to cover those other stats that are just a little bit low. So now that's the idea. And you might ask, well, are you leveling them up? No, it's going to be level 0. Are you doing matches and variants? Yes, I actually am. I'm putting them into the training center. It's only 30 minutes for each. So to do all 100 matches, it's only 30 minutes on a WrestleMania 40. To do all 10 variants or however many variants you got, it is only 30 minutes. So as you see, I'm in the process right now of just doing all the matches and all the variants of all of my WrestleMania 40s. And that's going to just boost them up just a little bit. All right, so I made a table with all the managers, action supports, and superstars that you could use for the ideal setup for what I'm doing in War Games. And hopefully you find a, you know, combination that you can use effectively. And like I said, since this is season 11, we haven't had War Games yet. I don't know 100% how well this is going to work. But in theory, I feel like this is a, I don't know, big brain idea. And so that's what I'm sticking with, and that's what we're working with. So at least as far as the manager action support setup and superstar setup goes, Paul Heyman as the manager, Pump It Up as the action supports is by far the best combination. It is the most superstars that you can have in there. And so by having Paul Heyman as your manager, by having Pump It Up uses speed and charisma as the action support. Now, if you put in two action supports of Pump It Up, that's fantastic. That's perfect. That's the ideal way to do it. But there are, other options like Second Wind that you can put in there if you don't have two Pump It Ups. But all of the superstars, now the idea is to put in all superstars in which the power toughness of the superstar is their worst stat. Because the Paul Heyman is going to boost up all of the superstars where power toughness is the worst. And for the females, WrestleMania 40, it is that is the most prevalent. I mean, it's the most used. Becky Lynch, Bayley, Tiffany Stratton, Liv Morgan, Naomi, Dakota Kai, and Scarlett. You have, you know, arrow options, and you have lots of different superstars. So, you know, the Paul Heyman Pump It Up setup is by far the best. What I'm using is Ted DiBiase and Undisputed. I have actually two Feral Undisputeds, but I thought about proing it, or actually it's two Invasion Undisputeds. I also have Second Wind though, so I'm unsure about if I want to do two singles or pro up the Undisputed, so it's kind of like up in the air to me. But either way, it's Io Sky, Roxanne Perez. It's not a bad setup. I mean, all of them either are left or right. Now we're going to come into ones that just, they don't have any options, to be honest, at least ideal setup wise. And that's Brandi Rhodes, who's toughness, charisma, and then the microphone, which is power and speed. There are no power speed females in the game. And so at least in WrestleMania 40, I didn't look in any other tiers or anything, but there are no power speed females in WrestleMania 40. And so that kind of makes using them or this actual strategy not as effective. Can you put in Becky Lynch in here? Could you put in Bayley? Could you put in Tiffany Stratton? Could you put in any other WrestleMania 40 superstar? Yeah, you can, but it's not going to be like the ideal setup like I'm setting it up. You know, you want your manager's support card to support the worst stats of that superstar to kind of boost them up, you know? And so, sure, you could put in other, you know, other superstars, and that's totally fine. And, in this particular case, if you have Brandi Rhodes and you have a microphone, it's only these three managers and these three action supports where this setup works perfectly, okay? Where the action support is the complete opposite of the manager. And that's the number one ideal thing, okay? So I could say you could use any three of these with any of these three action supports. I think it's fine. When we get into the other managers, though, it's not as good. Miss Elizabeth, who is a power speed manager, there is no toughness charisma action support. And so, you know, the two stat action support that balances out with Miss Elizabeth, there just isn't one in the game. Now, if you have Second Wind, you can use that. Could you use a single stat guitar, which is toughness, and a WWE universe, which is charisma? Yeah, you can, but you're still leaving the other stat open later on in other rounds. Sensational Sherry. She is toughness, speed. The problem is the action support. There is no two stat action support that is a power charisma. And what's worse, there's no single stat power. And so we do have a single stat, which is a table, but it's a subtraction. You don't want a minus action support. You want a positive action support. And so your really only good options for your action supports, if you're using Sensational Sherry, is going to be WWE Universe, which is just a single stat and charisma, or Second Wind, which is the boost to all of them. Now, again, you can use this setup, but if you have two Second Winds, I think it would be fine if you use Sensational Sherry, because there are two superstars whose worst stat is a toughness speed. And so that is Jade and BFAP. And so you can put in those two superstars, run the same way that I am doing it with Io Sky and Roxanne Perez. Have them all the exact same, just those two superstars, and it'll work out okay. Now, last up, we got Mr. Stone, who is a speed charisma guy. And so these are going to be all of your power toughness superstars. And it's going to be similar to the same thing. The problem is that there's no action support that boosts up power toughness at the same time. And again, same thing as Sensational Sherry. There isn't even a single stat boost to power. And so you would have to use Second Wind twice. And so, you know, with me, I don't have two Second Winds. I think that this strategy is fine. It's just Second Wind stats, you know, aren't as high as the two stat action supports. And so that's why I kind of stick with the first three combinations over here rather than these last three. But they do have, you know, decent superstars that you can put in this combination. There are three superstars in which speed, charisma are their worst stats, and that's going to be Rhea, Asuka, and Ivy Nile. And so you can use Mr. Stone if you want. If you have a couple Second Winds, I think it'll be fine. It's just Second Wind, just the stats aren't that high. And so that's why I typically try to go for the action supports. So that's my deck. That's my strategy. And I think it's going to work out really well. Even better than last season, hopefully. I mean, we don't know yet. But like I said, we will be streaming today. If you want to come check out a stream over on Twitch, over on YouTube, definitely welcome. Would love to have you. We're going to test this out, and I don't know, man. I think it's going to work out great. Never really done it to this level. I mean, last season, the stats were just so low. It really didn't matter what cards you were throwing in there, right? Because your boosts on your managers were, you know, 10, 20 times the stats of your regular superstars. So now it's only going to be double. But I don't know, man. I just feel like that this strategy is going to work out really well with the manager boosting the weakest stats and the action supports covering the other ones. We'll just have to see. But either way, let me know in the comments, you know, what you think. If you have any other questions. Like I said, we did do a guide video, though. How to play war games and all that stuff. Just check that out in the description. The method will be exactly the same as this season. It's just the deck setup is a little different. Anyways, guys, hopefully I see everybody at the stream. Y'all take it easy. We're out. Peace.